sand shore,
off the sand shore. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I know I can stand secure. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I put my hope in your holy word. I put my hope in your holy word.
I have a living hope.
I have a living hope.
I have a future. Of the sign shore,
of the sign shore. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I know I can stand secure. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I put my hope in your holy word. I put my hope in your holy word. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I put my hope in your holy word. I put my hope in your holy word. I put my hope in your holy, holy word.
To be called a lamb. Good morning, dear parents, relatives, and friends. Welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. Today is a special day for us, a day which we have been looking forward to for a very long time. On this day, our hearts will be filled with joy and happiness as we receive this most precious gift, the body and blood of Jesus. We pray that through this sacrament which we are about to receive, we shall be nourished and strengthened to build our community of love and brotherhood, where justice, peace, and joy reigns. Jesus loves us and is waiting to come into our hearts, so that it is no longer we who live, but Christ will live in us.
My dear children, my dear parents, and everyone gathered here, welcome to this Eucharist. In a special way at the outset, we say thank you and congratulate the parents for leading their children to the sacrament of Jesus Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear Father, in the name of Jesus and on behalf of the parish community, we now present these children for the sacrament of Holy Communion. Abigail Mesquita, Aiden D'Souza, Adelaide Mesquita, Alexia DeCosta, Anaya Lewis, Callum D'Souza, Christian Pereira, Darian D'Souza, Dwayne Desai, Erica DeCosta, Jervis D'Souza, Harith Mesquita, Ian D'Souza, Jaden Gonsalves, Kaylin Kinney, Kelsey Coutinho, Leora Pinto, Naomi DeMello, Naomi Gonsalves, Nathan Luke, Rachel Anandappa, Ruel DeMello, Ruan Gonsalves, Samuel Dias, Shirl Rosario, Siona Almeida, Skylar Coutinho, Vernados Mesquita, Vinash Gonsalves, Johan Mendoza, Zinedine Pereira.
This is your great day. Jesus today gives himself to you. So we celebrate this day, okay? Jesus loves each one of us. And in the sacrament of the Eucharist, he truly comes and lives with us, so that it is not I, but Christ who lives in me. For the times that we have failed to understand this, let us now bow our heads and ask for Jesus' forgiveness. Let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Together we say, I confess. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We now glorify our Trinity.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, that may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Job. Job spoke, saying, "Has not man a hard service on earth? And are not his days like the days of a hired hand? Like a slave who longs for the shadow, and like a hired hand who looks for his wages, so am I allotted months of emptiness, and nights of misery are apportioned to me. When I lie down, I say, when shall I arise? But the night is long, and I am full of tossing till the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle, and come to their end without hope. Remember that my life is a breath. My eye will never again see good." The word of the Lord.
Our response shall be,
from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, if I preach the gospel, that gives me no ground for boasting, for necessities is laid upon me. Woe to me if I do not preach the gospel, for if I do this of my own will, I have a reward, but if not of my own will, I am still entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my reward? That in my preaching I may present the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel. For though I am free from all, I have made myself a servant to all, that I might win more of them. To the weak I became weak, that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that by all means I might save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, that I may share with them in its blessings. The word of the Lord. Kindly rise.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus left the synagogue and entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now, Simon's mother-in-law lay ill with a fever, and immediately they told him about her. And he came and took her by the hand and lifted her up, and the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening at sunset, they brought to him all who were sick or oppressed by demons, and the whole city was gathered together at the door. And he healed many who were sick with various diseases, and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak, because they knew him. And rising very early in the morning, while it was still dark, he departed and went to a desolate place, and there he prayed. And Simon and those who were with him searched for him, and they found him and said to him, "Everyone is looking for you." And he said to them, "Let us go on to the next town, that I may preach there also, for that is what I came for." And he went throughout all Galilee, preaching in their synagogues and casting out demons. The Gospel of the Lord.
Children, tired already? No? Okay, chalo. I have a story for you all. Now, when I tell the story, you all have to help me, okay? So be very attentive. On a hilltop, there are three trees. They are growing. They are small, okay? But these trees, all three of them, have dreams. We all have dreams. Do you all plan what you want to be in the future? Yes. See, you have to respond loudly, otherwise they will not be able to hear. Do you all dream?
Yes.
Do you all want to be something in the future?
Yes.
Okay. Likewise, these trees also had dreams and aspirations. Okay? So the first tree, he looked up at the night sky. Clear sky. What do you see in the night sky?
Stars.
So when he saw the night sky, he saw the stars, and they looked like diamonds. So he thought to himself, when I grow up, I will be a beautiful treasure chest. What do we put in treasure chests? Diamonds, gold, jewels. So this tree wanted to be a treasure chest which can hold beautiful and marvelous things. Okay? First tree. The second tree. The second tree looked on the side, and that tree saw a great ocean. Okay? Now in the ocean, the tree saw mighty waves. So the tree thought to himself, I will become a mighty ship, a strong one. What does a ship do? It sails. So this tree wanted to sail over the mighty tides, okay? But it also wanted to carry the greatest of kings, because kings need ships to travel. Is it so? Yes. So two trees are done, okay? The third tree is a very simple one. It looks at itself and says, wow, I love this mountain top and I want to stay here. But it also sees that there are people living around. So it looks at himself and says, I want to be a tall tree. So when people come and look at me, they look up and they think of God in the heaven. So what are the three dreams or three aspirations? What did the first tree want to be? Treasure chest. The second one? A mighty sailing strong ship. And the third one? A tall tree so that when people look at it, they think of God. Okay? Now don't forget these three dreams. Okay? Many years passed. Okay? In many years, they grew. They grew. Long, wide, tall. Okay? And then, one fine day, three woodcutters came. What does a woodcutter do? Cut trees. Y'all have ever seen a woodcutter cut trees, chop trees in the roadside? You've seen that, no? So these three woodcutters came to the mountain top. Okay? The first woodcutter looked at the first tree and said, wow, what a beautiful tree. The tree felt happy. Why? Because it always wanted to be seen as a beautiful tree. So the woodcutter said, this tree is something that is perfect for me, and chopped it off. The tree was happy. The tree was happy. Why? Because the woodcutter said what it would be? Beautiful. Okay? And that is what the tree wanted to be. The second woodcutter looked at the second tree and saw, wow, what a perfect, strong tree this is. I will use it, and chopped it off. The second tree also was happy. Why? Because it wanted to be strong and the woodcutter said so. It said that this is a strong tree. What about the third tree? When the woodcutter looked at it, what do you think happened to the third tree? Any guesses? Huh? Longer, taller? Okay, no guesses, okay. The third woodcutter was a lazy woodcutter. He did not want to be there. Okay? So he looked at it and he said, I will cut it regardless. No matter what it is, how it is, I will cut it. The third tree felt very sad. Nothing to do, no compliment also, right? So it felt very sad. And at the end, the third woodcutter chopped the tree. So all the three trees got chopped. The first woodcutter took the first tree to a carpenter. What does a carpenter do? Makes furniture. So when the tree saw the carpenter and the workshop, the tree was very happy. Because in the heart, the trees thought, wow, a carpenter will make me into a beautiful treasure chest. Exactly. But the carpenter looked at it and said, okay, good tree. It's a good one. And he made it into a feed box. What is a feed box? A feed box is where you put food for animals. Okay? So it's a wooden feed box. What do you think the tree felt? Sad? Happy? Happy? No? Very sad. So the tree felt sad, but it remained a feed box. Okay? The second woodcutter took the second tree to a shipyard. What happens at a shipyard? You all know. At shipyard, a shipbuilder builds all these mighty sailing ships. What do you think the second tree must have felt? Very happy, because I am at a shipyard and there are so many ships around. But the shipbuilder looked at it and said, okay, it is strong, but we need a sailing ship which is needed for fishing. So he made it into a small fishing ship, a boat, and put it in a lake. Now, what is put in the sailing ship for fishing? Fishing boat. What is a fishing boat used for? Catch fish. And fish smell very nice. Have you smelled fish in the market? So the tree also felt sad. because it was no longer a mighty sailing ship, but a small fishing boat, and in which there were smelly dead fish. Happy? Good story so far? Okay. The third woodcutter, the lazy one, he took the tree to a lumber yard. There, no one cares about the wood. So the guy took the tree and built it into two beams. You know what is a beam? This can be thought of as a beam, like a wooden beam, okay? Two. He made two and he kept it aside. How do you think the third tree felt? It is extremely sad. Firstly, he did not receive any compliment. Secondly, he was brought here and chopped without any reason. It doesn't even know what it will become. So what was the first tree's destiny now? What did it become? A feed box. What did it want it to be? Treasure chest. What about the second tree? What did it become? A fishing boat. What did it want to be? A mighty sailing ship. And the third tree? What it wanted to be? A tall tree. And what did it become? Just a piece of wood kept at the side. So what happened? All the trees forgot their dreams. And they were very disappointed. Very disappointed. But then, one cold starry night, a silent night, a mother kept a small baby in the feed box. And the tree realized that starlight is falling upon it, and it felt beautiful. The father of the child said, "I should have made a beautiful cradle for the baby." But the mother said, "No, this manger as it is beautiful." And suddenly the tree remembered its dream. Its dream was to hold greatest of treasures, right? And it realized that now, in this baby, it is holding the greatest treasure in the world. Many years passed by. The ship was at the lake. And a tired traveler came along with his friends and got into the ship, the boat. And it went out in the lake. As the night passed, there was a great storm. Now what happens to a boat in a storm? Mostly it will drown, right? But now in the storm, it is getting tossed around, okay? And it is afraid. Why? Because it will sink with all the travelers in the boat. But this tired traveler gets up, walks ahead, and tells the storm, "Peace, calm down." And the storm settles. At that moment, the second tree realizes that the king of heaven and earth, who commands even the storms, is sailing in me. I am carrying the greatest of kings on the lake. A few years pass by. The third tree is there in the lumber yard. Someone picks it up, puts it together, and a man is carrying it through the streets. And suddenly, the tree realizes that people are angry at it, shouting at it, spitting at it. How did the tree must have felt? Very bad, and it was feeling very sad. Then, the man who was carrying it was nailed to the same tree. Blood was there on the tree. The tree felt very, very ugly, very sad, very dirty. And that man died on that tree. And the tree was very dejected. But on the Sunday morning, the earth shook. When the earth shook, the tree realized something great has happened. A miracle has happened. The man who had died has risen again. Can you guess who the man is? Can you guess who the baby was? Can you guess who the man was in the boat?
Jesus!
Exactly. And you see, when Jesus was with the trees, their dreams actually came true. The first tree wanted to be a treasure chest, and when Jesus was placed in it as a baby, it realized it has the greatest of treasures with it. The second tree, which wanted to be a mighty sailing ship, was now, because of Jesus, able to be in a storm. And it did not worry anymore because Jesus calmed the storm. And the last tree realized that now and henceforth, whenever anyone looks at that tree, they will think of the God in heaven. Remember, that was the dream, right? Now, every time we look at the cross, who do we think of? God in heaven. My dear children, today is your special day. Today, Jesus comes from heaven on this altar in your lives to be part of you. All of you have dreams? Yes? Little loudly, others, they are sleeping. All of you have dreams? All of you want to be something in the future? In life, many things will happen. But remember, Jesus is with you. And when Jesus is with you, all your dreams will come true. Always remember this. So, now 2-3 things you have to do when you go back. First, never let forget this day. Okay? Never let yourself forget this day. Keep a photograph of it. Keep it in a small journal, a book or diary. Remind yourself that on this day, you received Jesus. All of you all celebrate birthdays? All of you all celebrate birthdays? They are not talking. Your special day, only you all should talk. All of us celebrate our birthdays. Don't you think we should celebrate this day? Sure? Say loudly. Now this yes is for your parents, so that they remember to celebrate this day as well for you. Okay? So two things. One, keep a photograph of this day with you. Keep it. Remind yourself every year. Second, celebrate this day with your family and your parents. You all will do this? Great? Sure? Together? Okay. Now let's get ready to receive Jesus, okay? As the children light the candle, we shall now have the renewal of the baptismal promises. Kindly rise and join the children too. My dear children, when you were baptized, you were not old enough to promise God that you would be His loving children. Today, you will be able to tell God what your godparents said for you at baptism. The first time you received the gift of a special love from God the Father was on the day of your baptism. You were called to be a child of God, and now that you are growing to love God more, make your own promise to Him.
God my Father,
God my Father,
today before you,
my family and friends,
I want to make
my own baptismal promises.
Jesus,
I want to live
more like you.
At this Holy Eucharist, give me
your life and strength,
to live my
baptismal promises.
Most Holy Spirit,
come live in me.
Make me your holy temple.
Do you believe in God the Father, creator of heaven and earth, who called you into life and know you by name and loves you?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary was crucified, died, and is risen from the dead to give you new life?
I do.
Do you want always to try and live the way your loving God wants you to live, by avoiding what is bad and trying to do what is good?
I do.
Do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who lives in you?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and everlasting life?
I do.
Father, we offer you the faith of these children. This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord, who through the Holy Spirit lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus healed the people who suffered from diseases of both mind and body. Let us now place before God, our loving Father, through His only Son, the Divine Healer, our petitions. Our response shall be, Lord, listen to your children praying.
For our Pope, bishops, priests, and religious, especially Father Nelson, Father Denzel, Father Santan, and Father Umar, that through the Holy Spirit they be blessed with wisdom and courage to direct the lay faithful of the Church closer to our Lord Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to your children praying.
For the leaders of the world, that they may guide the actions of those who govern, and may they receive the grace to promote justice and equality towards the poor and less fortunate. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to your children praying.
For our parents, catechists, family members, and all those who have been instrumental in preparing us to receive the sacrament of First Holy Communion, that the Lord may pour upon them His Spirit of love and wisdom, blessing them abundantly for all that they do for us. We pray to the Lord.
For us communicants, that as we receive our Lord Jesus' body and blood today, that we may always be drawn closer to Him and through Him experience God's love and grace in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
For those in the healing ministry, such as doctors, nurses, technicians, and paramedics, that they may bring comfort and consolation to people. We pray to the Lord. For all of us present here, that empowered by this communitarian celebration of the Eucharist, we may grow more compassionate and caring towards our brothers and sisters. We pray to the Lord.
God, our loving Father, help us to imitate your Son, Jesus, who showed compassion on the sick and the suffering. Give us the grace to contribute towards the alleviation of suffering in our midst. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And you be seated. We shall now have the offertory. Children, please come forward with your love offerings. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of eternal life. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Oh.
Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Through Christ our Lord. Please be seated.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
For coming into our hearts.
We little children
shall always remember this day. Has heaven reached our eyes? With your body, Jesus, make me like you.
Obedient and kind.
Truthful and honest. Meek and humble.
Protect me.
From all dangers
of body and soul.
Bless all who I love.
My parents,
my brothers and sisters,
relatives and friends,
teachers and elders.
Jesus, I offer you myself.
Use me to make you known
and loved.
Teach and help me to love.
And help the poor and needy.
The sick and the suffering.
The dying and the oppressed.
May we continue.
To
receive you lovingly. Each time at the Holy Eucharist.
Each time at the Holy Eucharist.
Amen.
Amen.
On behalf of all the teachers, we take this opportunity to thank you all parents for all the cooperation that you have given us throughout this week, sending your children daily for practices and sometimes going late. We especially today would like to thank some of the parents who have taken some extra trouble in sending their children regularly for classes. We had 27 classes and there were some who attended all 27 classes, not taking one absentee. So today we would like to appreciate these children and their parents. So I would like to call upon Adelaide Mesquita and her parents to come forward to take her certificate and a gift. Anaya Lewis and her parents Melissa and Cedric. Callum D'Souza and his parents, Rebecca and Logan. Jaden Gonsalves and his parents, Farita and Marshall. Rachel Anandappa and her parents Rubian and Valerian. A special mention is for Christmas Mass. I had asked all the children for the midnight Mass to come in front and sit down. She was the only child who came right in front. So give her a hand for that. And finally, Vinash Gonsalves and her parents Conses Kiao and Jeffrey Gonsalves. We'll now have the vote of thanks on behalf of the parents.
Good morning, everyone. I'm overjoyed and thrilled to speak on behalf of all the parents of our little angels who have received Jesus today. A big thank you to our parish priest, Father Nelson, Father Omar, Father Denzel, and Father Santan. Also, a special gratitude to all the dedicated teachers, Sister Violet, Vidalia Miss, Stan Sir, who have worked hard to prepare our children for this meaningful day. Your selfless service means a lot to us. A big thanks to Rudolph for our sacristy, for setting up this beautiful setup of the altar, all the altar services, and not forgetting the little children of the Joycee Choir who have really made this a wonderful moment for us. A heartfelt thank you to all the sponsors that have sponsored for the candles and the flowers arrangement, also for the snack boxes and the gifts for the children. We appreciate everyone's time and effort to make this day possible. Let's continue to serve and be a light to the world. Take care, God bless, and remember Jesus loves you all. Have a wonderful day ahead.
My dear people, these children have received the blessing of Christ Himself through His body and blood. Can we give them a big round of applause? Louder. My dear children, this was for you. Now these final blessings are also for you and for all. So bow your heads and your response should be Amen. The Lord be with you. May the Lord bless you and keep you. Amen. All together. Amen. May He let His face shine upon you and show you His mercy. Amen. May He turn His countenance towards you and give you His peace. Amen. And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever and ever. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your life. Thanks be to God.
Bye. steadfast love is great. He is great to the heavens, and thy faithfulness, thy faithfulness to the clouds. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens. Let thy glory be over all the earth. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens. Let thy glory be over all the earth. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens. Let thy glory exalted, O God, above the heavens. Let thy glory be over all the
can fathom I stand.